In the next minute, I'm just going to invite my brother. He's very blessed man of God. He's gifted. He has a word of knowledge, word of wisdom. He's blessed. Amen. He's going to encourage us with the word of God for another, maybe for 5 or 6 minutes. But خلينا كده نرحب بأخونا بابا دانيال that he's going to encourage us with the word of God.
Praise God.
Amen.
English or Arabic?
English.
Italian, something?
I'll just keep on one language, make it quick.
Okay. Amen. Good, thanks.
There's nothing new.
Amen.
Amen. And there's no one is coming to rescue nobody. Amen?
Amen.
No one is coming. The only help is here. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The only help that is coming is already here now. Hallelujah.
Amen.
No one's coming from outside. All the help is in the inside now. Praise the Lord. That's me and you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's me and you. We come to church, we hope for someone to come. But the good news is that no one is coming. Because you are the help. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Last year, it makes you realize that you need to involve God in your life more than ever before. Praise the Lord. Time is fast running out. There's no time to waste. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Wherever you're sitting now, today you are the oldest you have ever been.
That's right.
And also the youngest you will ever be again. Nothing new. Time is running. Life is flying. Hallelujah. And we're here not by mistake. We're here for a reason and a season. We're here for a purpose. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We're here for a purpose. In the beginning was the Word of God. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And that Word was manifest into flesh and became a living being. The same way God says, I send my Word out of my mouth, and will not come back unto me empty, but will fulfill what it was sent for. That Word is me and you. It's not a cliche. It's not a cliche. We're following the same example of our brother Jesus. Released by Father God, the same way we're released. For a reason. He finished his mission and he said it is finished and it's gone. Paul the apostle came for the same example and he said, I have finished the race and I have fought a good fight and I've kept the faith. That's his final words and it's gone. What will you say when you finish? And when you're gone? Sometimes we say, oh, maybe it's just our pastors that weren't supposed to do the job. That's a lie. They're supposed to get you doing the job. Praise the Lord. They're supposed to get you doing the job. Hallelujah. Let's check out something very quickly and I'm done. Hosea 4 verse 6 says this. My people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge. Because they have rejected knowledge, I have also rejected them. Not to be a priest unto me. Not to be a priest unto me. And seeing that you have rejected my word, I will also reject your kids. This is word to the parents and to the married couple. We want our kids to go right, but we are going wrong. It will not happen. He says, teach them in the way that they might go. So when they grow up, they will not depart away from it. But then we're teaching them in the way that they're not supposed to go, and they already ran away. They already ran away. And the reason for that is because in the first place, you got married with no idea why you got married. I'm not a married person, but I'm grown by revelation and I'm grown by other people's mistakes. That's called wisdom. Many people, they grow by time, they just give a time. When they're suffering, and they just give a time. That's called ignorance. Some people, they know they're supposed to change some gears, but they choose to drive thing in an automatic car, and you didn't change no gears, and you're stuck in the same place. There's no way you're going ahead. Praise the Lord. Our kids, they need to change, but then we're going to see the example in the same time. Why is the church full of mothers but no fathers? Because Jesus is a real man. Praise the Lord. You realize fathers at home, or ladies, you realize your husband at home, you're like, ah, this guy failed, he missed it. And then you take a photo of your husband and your two boys and you put it on Facebook and you say, my boys. Why? Because you realize that you're a boy, it's not a man yet. Because in every man, there's a child, there's a boy. And in every boy, in that man himself, there's a boy inside of him and there's a man inside of him. That man will only come out if you make room for him to grow.
Yes.
And that man will grow. Only if you as a wife make room. grow. My brother, she's making room for you to grow. And in the same time, you make room for her gift to be great. That's the reason for marriage. Not just to go for dates and spend some money here and come back home and start getting angry. You're making room for her, for her gift to be great, because you discover her purpose on earth. And now she's happy living her life, fulfilling her purpose on earth. And she's making room for you to grow. Amen. That's why ladies are mature quicker than men. They grow fast. There are many uncles at home, fathers at home, big boys at home, wearing nappies. The head is very up, but in the inside in here, they're wearing nappies. Inside their heart, they're crying out, they're shouting for help and support and justice. But they're the same people that are supposed to be the teacher at home, the protector and the provider. But at the same time, now they're looking up to you as a wife. Why? Because you are a mother, you nurture. And they're looking up to you to grow. But then it comes to a place where they're looking up to you. Because they need to be nurtured. Their kids need to be nurtured. In the inside of you as a wife or as a mother, there's a little girl as well. There's a little girl as well. And the man has to discover that. Or else, everyone's going empty in marriage, fights every day, then the kids go that direction. He says that because you have rejected the knowledge of my will. I will also reject you not to be a priest unto me. The word priest means representative. God says, then because you have nothing in the inside of you to represent me to the people, then you will not be a minister. Then it's because you rejected that, now there's nothing in you to give to the people, I will also reject your kids. It's not that God rejected them, it's that because they in the first place rejected God. Then God wants someone to represent him on earth. But yet, the man rejected the word of God. And they want to represent God. God says, you will not be my representative. There is no way. And then the same way, your kids as well will not do that. Why? Because there's nothing in you that you put in them. There's nothing in you that you put in them. Praise the Lord. It's not that God rejected us. It is us that rejected God. And to get back quickly and help the kids, you fix yourself first as a husband and a wife.
Amen.
As a husband and a wife. Praise God. Your husband is crying in the inside of him, in the inside there. He's crying like a child, but you don't know that. He's crying like a child. He's just waiting for him to give him tissue while his tears. Praise the Lord. What God is saying here is, it's time to grow. It's time to grow. A healthy marriage is a healthy house. And a healthy house will give a healthy church.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Yes. A healthy church. There's many mothers in the church, not just only in this church, all around the world. Because Jesus is a real man.
Yes.
The woman of the well, she had five husbands. And the one she's with is not her husband. And the sixth man, Jesus Christ, came. The sixth man came. She found a perfect man.
Yes.
She found a real man. And that's what God wants in our fathers, uncles, they're all in Fusco everywhere. Some aunties going there doing witchcraft. They're running to Indians nowadays. They think that Nigerian witchcraft is weak now. They're running now to Indian witchcraft. That will not help you. My time is up. That will not help you. That will not help you. Last scripture, Proverbs 20 verse 5. It says, counsel is in the heart of man like deep water, but only a man of understanding will draw it out. Amen. That word counsel means purpose, means will, and means plan, and it means goals.
Amen.
The will of God in your life is like deep water. It's inside of you now. It doesn't need a prophecy for you to know it. You know it. That's why it gives you a hard time to sleep at night. You're not comfortable. There's some things that annoy you. They're indication God's trying to say, this is what you're supposed to solve in life. Get rid of it quickly. But then it says, only a man of understanding will draw it out. That's why it says in Colossians chapter 1 verse 9, it says, my desire for you is to know the knowledge of the will of God, that you might be filled with the knowledge of the will of God in all wisdom and within the spiritual understanding. When a cup is full, what's in there to be filled up? Nothing. The cup is full. That's what God wants you to be filled with the knowledge of his will, like deep water. With all wisdom, how much is old? A lot. There's nothing left out of old. and then with a spiritual understanding. Praise the Lord. And that's the reason for marriage. And it's a job for a husband to identify what is in the wife and make that gift great. And when that gift is great, the kids will say, wow, that's my dad. Because every boy wants to be like your dad. Every boy wants to be like their dad. There's no boy who's not going to be like their dad. And then if your son sees you beating up the mom, this kid will remain hurt. And he will not tell you. Until the age 60. Maybe he'll confess later at age 60. But then he beat up the mom when he was 6. And the pain remained there. Why? Because you tell them, obey your mother and your father. But you forget the last part, it says, but parents do not provoke your children. Yeah. You provoke them, they say, look, you're not my dad, but you're my parent. What that means, says I'm staying in your house, you provide for me until I get out of here. So basically, they already cut you off. Praise the Lord. Amen. Time to grow. Yes. Time to grow. Amen. It starts from the top, and we reach down the bottom. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen.